can't they do something about women that have suffered with cancer mm-hmm. and a mastectomy? And I started doing a little bit of checking. I went to the phone book, and I started looking for plastic surgeons. Well, we don't have that many in the area. And I wrote to a doctor. I consulted doctors in my hometown. And the response was negative to a certain extent, not encouraging. But I still kept thinking that there's, you know, somewhere.
Gotta be something, sure.
Yes, right. So quite by chance, in our Sunday paper, I came across a very small article in there about Dr. Stallings and the work that he had been doing, also involving post-mastectomy patients. Now, there wasn't a lot to go on to write to him. I wrote to the Institute of Plastic Surgery in Des Moines. And I really, honestly, did not expect an answer. I didn't have a referral from a doctor. I just took a chance and I wrote. And in about 2 weeks' time, he answered my letter. And it was very encouraging.
Mm-hmm.
Very encouraging. And he said that he would need a little history, but to come and see him. And we talk about it, which is what I did.
When you talked to her, what did you tell her, doctor?
Let me answer that by bringing in the fact that 90,000 mastectomies are done in this country per year. One in 15 women will develop breast cancer sometime during their lives. Let me also say that the breast can be rebuilt after any type of mastectomy, even the radical mastectomy such as Patty had. So what we did was to borrow a muscle from her arm called the bicep muscle to swing it over to create the fold in front of the arm. And then we brought up some tissue from her abdomen that actually hangs down from her stomach called the greater omentum, and brought that up to replace some of the scarred tissue. And then we borrowed skin from her thigh to put over this. And that is the first stage of the surgery. Then later on, we put in a breast implant similar to this. This is a high-grade medical plastic. It is filled with physiologic saline or salt water, which is very similar to the body fluid. And we then made her a nipple by borrowing tissue from outside her vagina, called the labia minora.
Now, when you borrow tissue, as you did from three or four parts of her body, what do you replace in the borrowed area? Like when you borrow the bicep?
No.
You know what I'm saying to you?
I do know what you're saying.
You know, you take skin from the
right.
thigh, you take muscle
right.
from here. I mean, what
right.
takes the place of what
okay.
you took away?
Let me explain it. Let me explain it this way, that our body generally has at least two muscles for almost every function. So we borrow the bicep, and another muscle called the brachialis muscle takes over the function. And Patty gets along very well. She has some degree of weakness when she lifts weights up this way, but otherwise mm-hmm. she gets along very well. Now, we borrow partial thickness of skin, which heals and graft up here. But literally today, with plastic surgery, we can borrow virtually from every part of the
and
body.
And like then, forgive me, but I got to ask, when you take skin from an area, then is that area scarred, deformed, discolored in any way, or does it heal back and everything's just fine?
Well, it does heal back, and usually it's pinkish for about 6 months to
mm-hmm.
a year.
Mm-hmm. I think, what are you trying to say, you know, I have more scars now than what I had before? Is this what you're wondering?
Well,
about?
I wasn't wondering about that, but as
mm-hmm.
long as you bring it up, do you?
Yes, I do. I have a scar here, if you want to call, you know, the
mm-hmm.
graft, the incision on the abdomen, and the incision on the arm. I mean, I have not lost the use of this arm at all.
Mm-hmm.
But when I consider that the scar I had before, the scar I was suffering inside, I mean, the scars I have now are nothing They don't bother me in the least. I wear cutoffs. I, for the first time in 2 years, have worn a bathing suit, which is, it's a great feeling. It really is. The scar on my arm doesn't bother me at all, the incision.
Mm-hmm.
Not at all. It might bother somebody else to look at it, but it certainly doesn't bother me.
As you say, compared to the greater scar
that
you had psychologically before you met him.
Absolutely.
Exactly. Right.
I only have 2 minutes left here, and I want to ask you, because many people who are watching this no doubt will have an interest in the two procedures that you've discussed here concerning Patty and Darwin and Vera, and other problems, whether it's nose job, as you call them, or eye lift, or whatever. How can people tell if a plastic surgeon or cosmetic surgeon knows what he or she is doing? Because there are, as there are in every branch of every profession, some people who are not as competent as they should be, and people who might do procedures that aren't really proved but are rather experimental. How can a patient tell? What questions do they ask?
Tom, I would say that there are perhaps three or four questions that should be asked by the prospective patient. First of all, the plastic surgeon should be certified by the American Board of Plastic Surgery, which indicates that he has taken a prescribed course of training and he's passed two very grueling examinations. Then one should meet the plastic surgeon and see if one can entrust their body image, their not only their physical health but their psychological health to this man.
Mm-hmm.
I think speaking with the family doctor is very helpful, checking with the county medical society, the state medical society, all of these things are very helpful. Probably the best single way, you know, once you have ascertained that he is certified by the American Board of Plastic Surgery, is to talk to some of his patients and see what they think of the man, of his work, etc.
If Patty or Darwin had asked you for a list of patients for referral...
I did.
You furnished them immediately?
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me say this, that
I mean, if a doctor wouldn't give a prospective patient, hey, here are three people that I've worked with on this, like if he wouldn't want you to talk to anybody, should you look out then?
Well, I think so, Tom, but it's only ethical to do this if the patient volunteers,
mm-hmm.
for example. There has to be a voluntary release before one can do this.
I understand. But thank you. I have to say thank you all because I'm out of time. Patty Koppmann, thank you so much for being here with
thank
us in
you,
California
Tom.
Tonight. Dr. Jim Stallings, thank you. Darwin and Vera, thank you very much for being here and continued good health and success to all of you. We will continue after these words from our affiliated stations.
Nelson Brothers, where your good life dreams come true. See a world of living room ensembles. Magnificent living rooms, Nelson value price to give you everything from the rugs on the floor to the pictures on the wall. At Nelson Brothers, your credit power gives you buying power. And
Nelson Brothers wouldn't think of charging you for delivery.
Nelson Brothers open Monday and Thursday night until 9, all day Sunday, 10 to 5.
Nelson Brothers loves me, and they'll love you too.
I think they would all wash out, just right out.
Valerie Rosato is being challenged on Tide's hidden camera.
You look at this dirt. This dirt is
grounded.
Ground through into the
sure.
pocket.
Yeah.
Into the pocket. And you could get that out.
I'm sure I could.
If you could get this dirt out, I would give you a year's supply of detergent.
Oh. I think that would be super.
Pick your detergent.
I don't think.
Which one is it?
Tide.
Oh. Why is that important to you?
Well, I've always used Tide.
Does it really matter?
Yes.
What about these? I mean,
I've tried a couple of these, and I've always gone back to Tide.
You wouldn't feel confident with any other detergent?
No.
I'll get you some Tide.
You see, it's gone. Oh, yeah, it comes out beautifully. I just take it for granted.
Why does Valerie Rosato insist on Tide? Because she knows the dirt you see the most is the dirt Tide cleans the best.
You got your year supply of Tide.
That's super.
Everybody's hurrying to Goldblatt's for good old-fashioned savings. It's Goldblatt's fabulous one-day-only sale tomorrow, Thursday. Goldblatt's great low prices on brand-new items, values in every department, with extra late shopping hours to help you save even more. Look at these great values.
Save $7 on Oster 10-speed blender, only $19.99. Colgate toothpaste with MFP, only 89 cents each. Hurry to Goldblatt's one-day-only sale tomorrow and bring a friend.
For all all the men and women watching this program tonight who may want some information about what has been discussed here, name a book, whatever, please write us and we'll be very happy to furnish you with it. And maybe it will help change your life too. Tomorrow night, as I say, we have our famous Tomorrow Show potpourri, including the 16,000 tickets to television programs and other stuff. Thank you for being with us tonight. Sweet dreams from Los Angeles, and good night, everybody.
It's taken Johnny Carson 15 years to make Friday's show, and you can see it all in a special two-hour program featuring some classic moments from his favorite shows. Dumbo Louise, Burt Reynolds, Don Rickles, Frank Sinatra, Jimmy Stewart, and more. The 15th anniversary of The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson, Friday at 11:30, 10:30 Central and Mountain on NBC.
W-E-D-N-E-S-D-A-Y is better than candy, better than pop. Wednesday is Christmas candy day.
We're going to do something to this wool coat you would never do intentionally. Burn a hole right through it. This is the Texative Fabric Repair Kit. Watch how it repairs the hole. First, we cut up some threads and mix them with Texative. We fill the back of the hole with the cut threads, apply a patch, and iron using Texative protective paper. Look, even when magnified, you can hardly see the repair. And Texative will repair holes in most other fabrics, even polyesters. And not just holes, but rips and tears. These polyester slacks look ruined, but repairing them with Texative is even easier than repairing holes, because Texative welds fabric back together to last the life of the garment. And with Texative adhesive film, you can even hem this easily. Put in zippers and do appliques. The Texative Fabric Repair Kit for burns, holes, rips and tears, hems, and appliques.
Repair kit $3.98 this week at Walgreens, Woolworth, Woolco, Osco, Turnstile, and Indiana Riverty Drug Stores. Marcus Welby, MD, weekdays at 3:30 here on Channel 5.
The name, Dr. Richard Kimball. The destination, Death Row State Prison. The irony, Richard Kimball is innocent. Proved guilty, what Richard Kimball could not prove was that moments before discovering his murdered wife's body, he saw a one-armed man running from the vicinity of his home. Richard Kimball ponders his fate as he looks at the world for the last time and sees only darkness. But in that darkness, fate moves its huge hand. A QM production starring David Jansen as the fugitive, with guest stars Ed Nelson, Carol O'Connor,